بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. This question comes from Dr. Baha. How can I treat hyperammonemia in neonate? Actually, the baby with hyperammonemia, it will be presented with metabolic crisis or metabolic derangement or metabolic crisis. Metabolic crisis like shock. It will came with shock. So you have to treat ABC, airway and breathing and circulatory insufficiency. So ABC, you have to maintain the airway and maintain the airway and monitor the airway and manage the airway. So you have to open the airway and monitor the airway by cardiorespiratory monitor or pulse oximeter, and also you have to monitor this patient clinically and biochemically, and also you have to manage the airway. Manage the airway, this means you have to intubate this patient. You have to intubate, and the goal for mechanical ventilation in the patient with hyperammonemia is to produce mild respiratory alkalosis. Mild respiratory alkalosis, this means to keep the PCO2 or the partial arterial CO2 between 30 to 35 millimeter mercury, between 30 to 35 millimeter mercury. So you have to ABC, then you have to intubate the patient, and the goal for mechanical ventilation to produce mild respiratory acidosis. After that, you have to treat if there is any circulatory insufficiency. You have to insert line, and I take the specific investigation or laboratory studies, and this is called initial and specific. You can take the CBC and take the electrolytes, and you take the specific like serum and urine amino acid and urine organic acid and pyruvate and the blood gas, and you can take carnitine and acyl carnitine. So you have to secure line and take the laboratory study. Then if the baby is shocked or hypovolemic, you have to give volume expander, and you have to correct all metabolic derangement. If there is acidosis, you have to correct it. If there is anemia, you have to correct it. After you secure the airway and the ABC, and you secure the line, and you treat the metabolic derangement and the hypovolemia, after that you can go for specific medications, and you call it nitrogen scavenger to increase the clearance of the ammonia, like what sodium benzoate and sodium phenylacetate and arginine. First of all, you have, if you will go systematic approach, first you take the laboratory investigations. The specific laboratory investigation like serum and urine amino acid and urine organic acid and pyruvate and blood gas and carnitine and acyl carnitine. Then you have to secure central axis. For why central axis? For high concentration of dextrose infusion, and also for probability of this patient need dialysis. Call it continuous renal replacement therapy. Continuous renal, call it CURAT. CURAT, this is continuous renal replacement therapy. Maybe this patient need dialysis. Protein free nutritional support. Glucose infusion rate should be 12 milligram per kg per minute. Why? To prevent the catabolic state. To prevent the catabolic state. Also, you have to correct the hypovolemia, anemia, acidosis. If there is any, because the baby will present with metabolic crisis, like shock, like pictures. So if there is hypovolemia, you have to give volume expander or entropes. And anemia, you have to correct the anemia. If you need blood, you have to give blood and acidosis. And also, we mentioned to intubate the patient and to keep the goal for mechanical ventilation. To keep the CO2, the PeCO2 between 30 to 35 millimeter mercury, and you have to monitor his patient clinical and biochemical, and you insert urinary catheter to monitor the urine output, because actually there is acidosis or hypoxemia. It lead to poor tissue perfusion. And after that, you start the specific medication, or call it nitrogen scavenger, to increase the ammonia clearance, like sodium benzoate and sodium phenylacetate. You have to give the loading and continuous infusions, and arginine hydrochloride. It will give loading and continuous also, and you have to check the blood gas before and after the loading dose of arginine, because the acidosis. And neomycin if the baby is more than 2 days, and also you can give lactuolase as needed. Why neomycin and lactuolase? Just to decrease the intestinal production of the ammonia. So we need to decrease the production of the ammonia. and increase the excretion of the ammonia by nitrogen scavenger. Nitrogen scavenger, sodium benzoate and sodium phenylacetate and arginine. There is magic medication called it aminol. Aminol, this is combination between sodium, not benzoate, phenylacetate and arginine. So phenylacetate, sodium phenylacetate and arginine. This is magic medication combination between the phenyl, the sodium phenylacetate, and also the arginine. So the specific medication to start it immediately, and actually due to hyperammonemia and consider it likely due to urea cycle defect, you have to start it with 250. This is sodium benzoate and sodium phenylacetate. Will start with 250 milligram per kg as loading dose over 1 to 0.5 or 1.5 an hour, followed by continuous infusion to 25 ml per kg dextrose 10 water at 25 milligram per kg per day, and arginine for sure it will be 10% loading with 2 ml per kg. It will be 0.2 gram per kg diluted in D10 water over 1.5 an hour, followed by 2 ml per kg per day by continuous infusion. And the arterial blood gas should be examined after administration of the loading dose, because acidosis may occur and should be corrected, and should be also corrected. And you have to start with Neomycin. How much will start it? 50 milligram per kg per day PR every 6 hours, only in neonate more than 2 days of age for 48 hours, only for more than 2 days, and the baby will be more than 2 days and for 48 hours. Or lactulose, it will be 2.5 ml NGT or PO, TID and BRN also may be used for few days, just only 2 to 3 days. Why? To decrease the intestinal production of the ammonia. Decrease intestinal production of the ammonia. So how to treat hyperammonemia? ABC, secure the airway and breathing and circulatory insufficiency. So this patient, you have to intubate. What is the goal of mechanical ventilation? To produce mild respiratory acidosis, to keep the BeCO2 between 30 to 35 millimeter mercury. Then after that, you have to monitor this patient clinically and biochemically and urine output, because the tissue hypoxia. And also after this monitor, you have to secure big line, central line. Why central line? Due to two reasons. We need high glucose concentration. Almost it will be more than 12. The glucose infusion rate, it will be more than 12 milligram per kg per minute. And also this patient might need dialysis or curat. We call it continuous renal replacement therapy. And also protein-free nutritional support. It will be high glucose to prevent the catabolic state. And you have to correct all metabolic derangement or hypovolemia or anemia or acidosis. And also you have to insert urinary catheter, monitor the urine output, and you have to give the specific medications or call it nitrogen scavenger, sodium benzoate and sodium phenylacetate loading and continuous. And also we have to give arginine hydrochloride. This is loading and continuous also, and you have to check the blood gas before and after and corrected the acidosis if it's happened. Neomycin and lactulose if the baby more than 2 days and for 2 days also. Why? To decrease the intestinal production of the ammonia. So ABC, then mechanical ventilation, you have to insert central line, you take the investigation, correct or the circulatory insufficiency. If there is anemia or metabolic acidosis, you have to correct it. You have to keep the CO2 between 30 to 35, and you have to monitor the patient clinical biochemical, and you insert urinary catheter to monitor the urine output. Then a specific medication. What is the specific medication? Sodium benzoate and sodium phenylacetate, arginine and neomycin and lactulose. If the baby more than 2 days, for 2 days, why? To decrease the intestinal production of the ammonia. This is nitrogen scavenger to increase the clearance of the ammonia. And the best medication actually nowadays is to call it aminol. It's actually a combination between the sodium phenylacetate and arginine. ومن أحياها فكأنما أحيا الناس جميعا. شكرا. سلام عليكم.